In this particular session, we are going to have a broad overview of what exactly is SharePoint. By the time this video ends, I would assure you that you will have a clear picture about what is SharePoint. All your doubts about what is SharePoint would be very clear, very much cleared after this video is completed. So we will start in this video with what is SharePoint. Then we will see high level features of SharePoint. Then there are something called as six pillars of SharePoint 2010. Basically, it covers mainly the features of SharePoint. Then we have to just know a little bit of history, though not immediately needed. But yes, what is the history of SharePoint? What is the SharePoint server's role in LAN network? What are the different components in SharePoint? And then the most important thing, which will be useful for everybody, would be the onion view of SharePoint. So what exactly is SharePoint? Let's try to see that first. SharePoint is an extensible web-based platform which contains various products and technologies aimed at development of corporate portals. Now, what exactly is the meaning of this? See, we know that using ASP.NET, we can build web applications. We can develop any kind of dynamic website. But then when we are using ASP.NET, we will have to do things from ground up. Whereas in case of SharePoint, it's a ready-made platform which has been already built using ASP.NET. And we, for a given particular corporate's requirement, we are going to extend that. We are going to add on to the existing capabilities of SharePoint for a specific corporate requirement. That is, we have a ready-made application. We simply customize that application as per our need. In other words, there is a out-of-the-box solution for most of the things ready-made available when we talk about SharePoint. And this environment is going to be used directly by the corporate portal. Now, what exactly is this portal term? We need to first know what is portal and what is website. In brief, to give you, a website is mostly informative. Like, for example, I would have deckensoft.com. It provides information about deckensoft. It gives you what all courses we are starting, the syllabus of each course, the testimonials of various students, what they have posted. So it is all about an organization where it is mostly, I would say, read-only information. Somewhere here and there we would do some dynamic content, but mostly it is read-only content. Whereas when we talk about portal is a form of website only again. But the content might come from many different locations and it need not be about a specific thing. The content can come from stock exchange, the content can come from news, maybe the sports, cricket scores can be seen there. The content can come from various sources and will be shown in single website, and that kind of website we call it as portal. Also, many a times it may happen that a portal requires you to log in. They will provide you a facility where you log in, and then after you log in, you look into the content of it. So for example, I can say yahoo.com, rediff.com, all these are portals. Whereas microsoft.com or deckensoft.com, our website, or sun.com, oracle.com, these are just websites. We would not call them as portals. So I am saying here, SharePoint is going to be used for development of corporate portals. What exactly is the meaning of this term, corporate portal? See, corporate means what? There are many people working in an organization and they have some culture to follow, they have some process to follow, they have some tasks to be done. So in these things, to collaborate, we make use of SharePoint web development platform. So more on this I'll talk about as we move further. But to be again noted, these products and technologies are referred to as SharePoint product and technologies. That means very, very important thing everybody should know is SharePoint by itself is not a software. SharePoint does not refer to any particular product or technology. SharePoint can be used like the way we use MS Office. We say Microsoft Office. What is MS Office further made up of? MS Word, Excel, PowerPoint, all these are different, many other products which are part of MS Office. So MS Office is a term which is again having many products within it. Like that only, Microsoft SharePoint is a term where we have again got many products and technologies as well coming into picture. So it allows individuals in an organization to easily create and manage their own collaborative websites. That's what I said. In an organization, individuals can create their own website. An organization can have a corporate website where collaboration. Collaboration is what? People communicating with each other, talking with each other. That is all possible here. It simplifies how people find and share information across boundaries and enable better informative decision. It seamlessly integrates with Microsoft Office and the Windows operating system. So as we go further, we will see more about what exactly is the meaning of this term seamless integration. But yes, there are many MS Office products like Excel, Word, PowerPoint. It has seamless integration with them. It has got a lot of features of the MS Windows directly made use of. So that is what is also one of the power of SharePoint. So I repeat once again, what is SharePoint? I would say in simple words, SharePoint is an application which is already developed by Microsoft using ASP.NET framework, and above that developed application, it gives us a facility where for a given corporate requirement, I can customize the SharePoint environment, maybe as an administrator, configure certain things, user configuration, certain services configuration, and so on. As a developer, we might program certain things and put it in that built, the pre-built platform, web-based platform. As a designer, I may change the layout, I may brand it according to my company's need. I may change cascading style sheets, I may change the complete look and feel, color schemes I can change, logo of whatever is the default logo I can change and replace with my company's logo. So these are the different roles which one has to play when they are doing SharePoint in their corporate portal. So the role of a person could be either administrator or could be a developer or could be a designer, and one more, the most important of all, the end user, the user role also will be there in SharePoint. So four different aspects of SharePoint is what we are going to also cover in our videos. See, there are many places where you will find that they teach you only about developer and they do not talk much about administrator. But according to me, I strongly believe that even if you want to play a role of developer in SharePoint environment, programming content, you should still know certain aspects of administrator. And if you are going to do only administration job, but you should still know what exactly are the different things which a developer is required, a designer can do, so that accordingly you can give them permissions. So having a holistic knowledge of all the different roles, usability, administrator, design, as well as developer, all the roles we are going to cover as a part of our training material. Now, as we are discussing these advantages of the SharePoint product and technologies, I would also say that yes, you would have more clear picture about what exactly is SharePoint. Rich UI, easy site editing and branding, ribbon interface. See, now you know this MS Word interface, this is ribbon interface, right? If I click here, this is a ribbon, MS Office ribbon this is. Like that, now in SharePoint 2010, we have got a ribbon interface for what all a user can do with the web page here. Imagine this as a browser window now. In the browser window, we are going to have the content here, and on top, whatever features we have on this particular page will be enabled and disabled or visible or invisible based on our identity. So this makes things much easier. Rather than clicking, searching in different menu options, this ribbon interface has, I would say, actually made MS Word also very, very easy. So exactly similar kind of look and feel is now provided in a SharePoint site. Let me show you this. So I go to Start menu and there is a SharePoint Central Administrator. I'm opening this on my machine. I have already installed SharePoint and that's how it is opening here. So this is the Central Administration website. Expand it. And as you do some selection here, for example, I select manage web application. Don't really worry about all these things now. You see, this is the ribbon interface. What all things are available to me will be enabled. What all things are not available to me are disabled. We can go to browse, wherein we have now this, we have the web design part. We'll see site action. A very, very sophisticated UI is what is available in SharePoint. So this is what I meant by very easy editing and branding. Now, what exactly is the meaning of this easy editing and branding? Later I'll show you. Once we create a site, all these things can be changed. I can probably change this logo. This is, of course, central administration website. This is the place from where we manage other websites. But when I create a website using this, I can change the logo. I can change this whole look and feel, complete branding as per my company requirement. I can use the colors as of my company's choice. So those things can all be done in an existing SharePoint site like this. So let me show you one SharePoint site as well. I can go here. I have developed already something. Deckensoft, which is my machine name, colon. I have developed it on port number 5000. See this. This is a website which has been developed using SharePoint. And I have hardly done anything to get this interface. Home page is there. I have, of course, added certain libraries. I have added certain lists here. This I have done manually. We are going to learn how to do all these things. But yes, you see ready-made out-of-the-box solution available. You can always go to page and you can do editing from here. You can manage your page here. Because I am administrator logged in on this machine now, I have got all these options enabled. But if I am not an administrator and if I have the basic privilege of only viewing, I would not have all these options enabled here. I would have only option of browsing. I would want to edit this page. I can simply click on this option, edit, and make the changes here. This is being modified. And once I am done, I can simply click on save and close, and the changes are saved. So like this, a SharePoint site can be easily developed with minimum efforts. The basic features would be readily available for us. Better site provisioning, quick development, that's what I meant. If you want to think of a site, there are certain ready-made templates. We can simply use them. There are templates many times given by some third party also. Like for example, I want to manage inventory. If I Google on internet, I can find a ready-made template which gives me information on how I can manage inventory of an organization. A ready-made template for collaboration, a ready-made template for blogs, a ready-made template for discussion forum. So you think of something, you'll have ready available feature. You have to sometimes only enable them, or sometimes you have to add them. Maybe sometimes you'll buy third party components and integrate it. No DBA required. Beautiful feature. Imagine now I have a table called as, my requirement in routine is managing users, or let's say managing products. I have a database. First I have to see how to create a table. Then I have to specify data types. Then I have to take care of indexing on certain columns so that performance of query will be higher. Once the database is created, then in the front end I'll have to write code which will allow me to insert, update, delete, get many records, get one record. We will do so many things. Imagine now, as an ASP.NET programmer, you are required to write code for managing products, managing users, managing invoices, managing orders, managing the, let us say, many other stuff, categories. Most of the time you'll note that you're actually repeating the same things again and again. Maybe your queries are changing, your insert statement is changing, update statement is changing, but then we are every time doing insert, update, delete, select and all these things only. Just the database part is changing. Now when it comes to a SharePoint, we have got a feature called as list. I just create a list. I have a list here, which I have created by name courses. And in these courses, I mean, what did I do? Did I manage database here? Absolutely not. I can simply go to list here and say I want to add one more column, click on this create column option and do it. I simply added these columns here. No database, no DBA required. We are never going to write, at least for basic things, insert, update, delete or select kind of statement. It is going to be created all using some ready-made GUI which is provided here. So this is the basic meaning of no DBA required. Now what exactly is this better document management? See, in any corporate, lot of information will be saved in documents. The project related documents would be there. In project, again, different versions of document, different modules may have different documents. So a lot of document management will be done. Most of the time, everybody manages these documents in a file system. Once they store it in the file system, they have real tough time in searching the relevant document whenever there is a need. Most important thing is, we'll have real tough time in knowing when was this document modified, who has actually modified this document. I want to track that all history. Now, basically managing through file system, these features are not there at all. So one might want to develop an application where a document every time edited, we upload into the database and we also provide information about who exactly modified, what exactly he did and this on. Doing this in ASP.NET from ground up is basically a nightmare, I would say. At least after knowing SharePoint, I would surely say it is a nightmare for the simple reason that SharePoint gives extraordinary document management facility out of the box with zero efforts required by a developer. You simply need to use or enable all the existing features of the document library. Now, one of the features, just to mention here, is versioning. Now, what exactly is versioning? See, every time I edit a document, I can give a version to that document. First time I create a document, I would give version 1.0. Second time when I edit, I'll give the version as 2.0. Third time I edit, I give the version as 3.0. Fourth time, I'll give 4.0. Suddenly I realize, no, the changes which I have made in last two versions are not relevant and I want to restore back the old version. Yes, SharePoint gives a ready-made facility for doing this. Complete versioning is taken care by SharePoint. SharePoint stores not only the initial last version, but also it stores the previous versions of the document. Then we can create document library where you can have attachments. Now what is this checked in, checked out? See, suppose there is a team of people working on a common set of documents. They might probably store it in one common directory and from there they start modifying it. There is a very good chance that two people at the same time open the same document and start editing them. One person saves it and immediately the second person also saves it, where the second person will override the changes made by the first person. This is really a critical problem. The changes made by the first person are completely lost. And suddenly, maybe some third person finds the whole document to be in consistent state. So for this, there are source safe servers available. Microsoft provides one called as Visual Source Safe. But when we talk about SharePoint, we don't need anything like a source safe server. The out of the box solution for managing document library has this check-in checkout facility where every time I select a document and I want to edit it, it can ask me, do you want to check out this document? And when I check out the document, the document in SharePoint gets locked. This document now cannot be edited by other users who are accessing the same document library. They'll have to wait till the person who has checked out makes changes and then checks in. The changes gets updated. Until then, the other users cannot edit the same document. So this ensures proper consistency in our document library, and this is built in. You do zero coding for this particular feature. Again, document workflow. Now what exactly is the document workflow? For example, now I as a designer I mean, I as a project analyst would understand certain things, and the moment I save the document, I may want immediately an email to go to the next level. And the next level when makes the changes, maybe the information should go to further next level. Let me take a simple scenario. In an organization, somebody wants to apply a leave. So there is a library where all the leave letters are uploaded. So now when a person applies for leave, immediately a mail should go to the corresponding person's manager, and a copy of the same mail should go to the HR. Then a manager may either approve or reject. When it is approved, again a confirmation should be sent to the HR or maybe the second level, the higher manager, for the further acceptance of the leave. So whole work, this is what is actually referred as workflow. How the whole system should move. If this is the case, this should happen. If that is the case, this should happen. This whole thing is referred as workflow. And this also is ready-made available. Approval workflow is ready-made available in document library kind of thing. SharePoint allows us to view documents within web browser. I can open an MS Word document within web browser. I can open an Excel document from within a web browser itself. It gives me this extra services, Excel services, Word services, which gives me the facility to open the document within the browser window. So I don't have to separately manage the document using MS Office products. That's really one of the beautiful features which SharePoint has. Permissions. Not every document need to be edited by every user. There are certain cases where some documents should be viewable by some users. Some documents should be maybe users can only add document. They cannot modify the document. So all these permissions again can be simply configured on a document library rather than manually taking care of it. So I would say overall an extraordinary document management system is available in SharePoint. We have to simply benefit from it by configuring certain areas. So I would say if somebody wants to do the same project in ASP.NET Core without making use of SharePoint, it would not take less than maybe 6 months or maybe even 1 year, I would say. So many features are built in into the document library system, document management system of SharePoint. Going further on the features, we have got automated emails and SMS alerts. See, SharePoint 2007 has only facility of email alerts, but now SharePoint 2010 has also got facility of SMS alerts. Now what exactly it means? I can have a document library, or maybe I can have a list where I add certain items or whatever documents, and I can configure it in such a way that if somebody deletes those items or edits those items or adds new items, immediately I should get an alert. For example, there is a training institute where there are a list of courses which are offered. Whenever a course is added, maybe the student would want to get an automated alert or maybe an automated SMS. We can simply configure for these also. We don't have to program it. Easy customization option, my site. Every user in SharePoint, there is a facility to host their own websites. I, as a user of SharePoint, I can have my own website where complete information about me can be presented, my colleagues can be presented, my photos can be uploaded, my hobbies can be presented, I can write some notes, I can add certain tags, this, that, so many things about myself, I can put it in the form of my site. And not only that, SharePoint has a feature called as web part, and these web parts can be completely customized. I can hide and show certain things. I don't like some things, I can simply hide them. I don't like certain things, I can move them on high priority. For example, now let us say I go to the home page, I go to browse, I go to home page, and I say edit. Once I do that, right now in this page we do not have any kind of web part. Yeah, this is a web part. These are the shared documents. Suddenly I decide that I don't want to see this. I can simply say minimize it. And further, if I know I never would use it, I can delete it. I restore it. I can even actually move this web part to another location. I would show you actually how to do that all when we do something more in depth. But yes, the whole site look and feel can be personalized as per your requirement. So next time when you log in, whatever was the last customized output, the same thing can be viewed by you every time. Built-in search engine. Google is built-in, I can say, in SharePoint. For a corporate, and if you want a facility like Google where searching has to be done, searching people, searching documents, searching lists, searching content, everything is ready-made. You have to absolutely do nothing. I would say nothing. Integration with Active Directory. Now, Active Directory is for basically creating users and groups. I have shown you this in the previous video. Once you have users and groups created in the Active Directory of your operating system, integrating with SharePoint is no time job. Any user which is there in Active Directory can be simply granted permission to access the SharePoint site, and thereafter he will have direct access. So seamless integration with Windows Active Directory, seamless integration with MS Office products, and there is a facility where I can generate reports in PDF format, Word format, and so many other formats. And yes, the biggest advantage of SharePoint, the communication which is going to happen between the team. Because today everybody knows success of any project is communication. Communication within the team members, communication with the client, communication with the other departments in the organization, that all can be collaborated in SharePoint. Here there are only two items listed, communication and task manager, but there are many more other collaboration features which are available in SharePoint. So let's see now the next important thing. What are the six pillars of SharePoint 2010? Now what do I mean by six pillars? Yeah, these are the six pillars: sites, communities, content, search, insights, composites. Basically, all these features which I have briefly explained earlier, they are now explained little more in detail. I would actually suggest you to read this document as it is, because many of the terms right now would not make much sense to you. They are all topics which we are actually going to cover as the course progresses. But still, just to give you overall boundary of what exactly SharePoint can do, let us discuss this whole thing. Yeah, let me again clarify, most of the things I am just going to read, and they have been written in simple plain language. There should not be any difficulty in understanding all these things. So yes, sites first to start with. Now what exactly it means, site: building and managing internal and external websites. See, many corporates nowadays have sites not just for internet. There are sites which we develop for example, now think of SharePoint 2010 sites as one stop shop for all business websites. It provides a full set of tools that people can use to create any kind of site, I am saying a very broadly used term here, plus a single infrastructure that simplifies site management. And I showed you, this is an infrastructure which is facilitating the site management. Central administration website is for managing the complete website, and this is for customizing the content in the website. This is a specific website we are talking about. Central administration is through this interface, through this environment, we create many other websites. For a team site for colleagues, from a team site for colleagues, to an extranet site for partners, to an intranet site for customers, people can share and publish information using one familiar system. So we can build any kind of site. We can build site for only site whose content is accessible only to our colleagues, not to the others. I can have a site which partners in my
other organization can access it. Subsidiaries can access it. I can build a site which is accessible freely for all the customers. They don't even have to log in. So, and all these things we are able to do in a single environment, and that is SharePoint environment. So, 2010 releases during release does bring a number of web content management improvements. Now, what are these things as web content management? More intuitive content authoring, editing experience with similar look and feel as MS Office. As I already told you, we are going to have now a ribbon kind of interface as if we have it in MS Office. Better support for websites that need to be available in multiple languages. See, nowadays internationalization, globalization is really very, very important. Not all countries people talk English. There are certain countries which do not use English and they want sites in their language only. For example, Japanese, Chinese, Spanish. So I can build a website, provide content in different languages so that based on your option of the language, automatically the content will get rendered. Multilingual website, globalization website. Yeah, that is a built-in feature again in SharePoint. Better organizing and categorizing of content. Yes, this is also one of the things. Improved search. Search was always there in 2007 or even before that for that matter. But now there has been improved features. In particular, there is something called as fast search which has been added. Integration with SharePoint search server has been provided, which gives you extra, which makes the search more informative in terms of providing some icons and all, and we'll see as we move further. Integration of web analytics on how your website is being is performing. You want to see now who is the user, who are the users who is using your web pages, from which IP the requests have come. Basically, there is something called as analytic tool given by Google also, but those are for internet websites. But I want to see how my website is performing, which pages are being more frequently visited, what are the search which are being more frequently done. All those things are built in SharePoint websites. Personalization via audience targeting. I can hide certain content on a website or show certain content on a website based on the identity of the user. What we are going to do is, based on certain conditions, we'll create a concept called as audience. And we also will already have something called as web parts. So we will say this web part is accessible to this audience set and is not accessible to this audience set. So whenever a user logs in, he will belong to some audience category, and accordingly the web part would be visible or invisible. For example, now I may have a site which gives information about various courses which my organization has, and it gives me facility also where I can download the course material. But now I do not want everybody to download the course material. I want only those people who are authorized, registered students of my organization should be able to download the course material. Others should not even be able to see the course material. So yes, I can configure this by creating an audience called as registered student, and the registered student audience would probably have access to only that particular section of the site. If the registered student is not logged in onto the site, he would not even view what exactly is there. So yes, we can have a complete site personalized based on audience targeting. We are going to practically see how to do that. Cross-browser support. Beautiful thing is, SharePoint is not just supported on Internet Explorer. SharePoint is also supported, properly viewed, on many other popular web browsers like Mozilla Firefox, or Google Chrome, or Safari browsers of Macintosh. So this is how the sites which can be developed in SharePoint are so popular or so easy. Now coming to communities, creating a social collaboration environment. See, we all very well know the popularity of Facebook and Twitter, where the people want to socialize themselves, people want to know others, people want to know, tell others what they are doing, share photographs, share their views, share audios, videos, and so many things. So these capabilities are now becoming integral part of even a corporate. Even in a corporate organization, their people want to share knowledge, and that's where yeah, communities play a very, very important role in a corporate portal too. So social communities like Facebook and Twitter are becoming normal for many of us. Now all this social media stuff is moving into workplace. It all boils down to providing modern approach to working together, collaborating and sharing knowledge. So that is what I meant. Now see, in corporates, knowledge has come to a stage where it can only grow by sharing. So much of content is already available everywhere. I can only grow my knowledge when I share my knowledge with you people. If I'm not sharing my knowledge with you people, I would simply shrink my knowledge. So how do I share? I need a platform to share my knowledge. Yes, SharePoint gives you facilities where you can simply create communities. You can simply have features of communities enabled, and everything about you can be known to others, and everything about others you can know, provided of course permissions are granted accordingly. So these capabilities needs to be a component of every piece of software we use nowadays. SharePoint works towards this goal by supporting the ability to create detailed user profile, use of modern tools for sharing and collaboration, including blogs and wikis. I'm sure you are pretty familiar with the term called as blog, where I write whatever I'm currently doing. I provide white papers on the topics where I specialize in. So that is kind of blog. Wikis is a site where content can be dynamically modified, pages can be added, and it is self-growable website. Editable web pages is referred as wikis. So I can create a wiki, you come in, you add your content, your views you add on the page, it will reflect immediately. Blog is mostly read-only. You may only at max add comments to the blog. But in case of wikis, anything can be changed. The whole page can be changed. So these kind of features are just built in into SharePoint, out-of-the-box solution again. The creation of special interest group communities to share knowledge and work on projects. So yes, we can have special communities like forums, I would say, in short, where somebody asks a question, others reply to that question. That is again a built-in. Interactivity via commenting and discussion around content items, social tagging. See, nowadays Web 2.0 specifications have been implemented by people, have become popular now. There, lot of tagging is going to happen. You might have seen pages with large font, small font, some text simply crumbled with each other. That is nothing but tagging of content. For example, now there is a page, let us say SharePoint training or MS.NET training. Now this MS.NET training is one thing which search engines would recognize, no doubt. But instead of searching MS.NET training, somebody might search for .NET course, .NET training institute. So we are actually tagging them. For me, .NET training institute is easy to remember. For somebody else, .NET training course is easy to remember. For somebody else, online training is easy. So we tag the same page with different options. So search engine recognize all these contents as same content and will give output in the search result. So yes, same content can be tagged. Same content can be, I as a user can bookmark my content so that I can always visit them as favorites. So these features are also built in into SharePoint. The creation of separate personal space or dashboard called My Sites. I already explained to you earlier. There is some feature called as My Site where I can keep track of my own content, work I'm doing in certain communities, the projects I'm working with, my colleagues and there. So many other things we are going to see in detail later. So yes, this is all about the communities features of SharePoint 2010. Then content. I told you earlier, you can easily manage your document, information and records. As a part of content functionality in SharePoint, you can have a direct integration with MS Office environment. So you can work on your documents in a familiar environment as MS Office. SharePoint 2010 provides the tools to help you work with both document and record management. Manage all your organization documents and other information, including controlling who can read and update them. I already told you earlier, permissions can be granted to few things. Permission need not be granted to few things. Categorize them as for easier search and retrieval. I can have different types of documents under different categories. I can put .NET course material at one place. I can put SharePoint course material at another place. I can put ASP.NET course material at another place. I can categorize them. So that is one of the beautiful feature again for content management. Mark them as official records. Log them so that others cannot make changes. These are all record management features which are built in into SharePoint. Then one of the beautiful, very beautiful feature of SharePoint 2010, search. You have Google in your own organization for private information. So SharePoint 2010 has two levels of search, built-in functionality which is greatly improved from 2007, and the new thing, fast search, as I told you earlier, offers additional functionality. Out of the box, SharePoint search includes the ability to search for information, search for people, including their expertise. I want to search on a site who is really a specialist in, let us say, one particular topic of our training. For example, who really is doing some kind of web caching. I would simply search people who are related to web caching, and immediately I get the list of all people. I just consult with them and my problem gets resolved very fast. So yes, for a particular expert, we can search. We can search on people. I would say I want people whose age is between this and this. Yeah, I'll get the list of people. Or some address I want to do search based upon information. Index content and data stored outside of SharePoint database. So we can have SharePoint database at one place. Of course, we don't do that. SharePoint itself manages its own database. But the content which is indexed is in a different location. And same content can be shared between different websites. That's one of the real good feature. So if somebody of one website is searching, he can also get, if enabled of course, the result of other websites within the same corporate environment. And refined search results based on taxonomies and metadata. Of course, you'll have to probably see this. You can actually classify your content. You can create metadata for your content. Metadata is basically data about data. So some items are there. To those items, you can add some extra information. And when you are searching, based upon the metadata also, the search is going to be done. And then we have a beautiful fast search feature. I told you, it gives features like thumbnails, previews of content within the search, within the result set. Right? Let me show you this. Okay, I have opened Bing. Microsoft Bing. I search for here Deckensoft. Now I click here and you see this is quick preview of the page. More information. For every page we have got some information. So this is quick preview. This feature is built in into SharePoint fast search. Refined results based on user profile and audience. Yeah, on the left hand side, of course here it is not there. But in SharePoint, you will see on the left hand side, you will be having a list of users. You can select a user and results for that particular user will be filtered and shown here. The ability to refine search results with filters like site, author, result site and more. All these are extraordinary facilities of fast search. Only when we see this feature enabled on our site, we would really enjoy it. So this is also one of the fourth pillar of a SharePoint site. Next we have insights. Digging for business intelligence. A key goal in any business is staying ahead of the competition. Very, very, very important sentence. Increasingly, the class of software called business intelligence plays an important role here. Business intelligence software is all about helping you with information using which we can make decision at the organization level. So we will have certain information in the form of text. Let us say that data is in the Excel format. That data, maybe I would use it for presenting it in a graphical format. Let us see this. With this release, you can use tools like Excel to gather and analyze data that is stored in SharePoint. In Excel format, the data is stored. Use SharePoint's native Excel service engine. There is something called an Excel service engine. We'll talk more about it later. To crunch data and build web-based reports. in same data can be used for generating different types of reports. Pull data together into different systems and present it in the SharePoint. So data can not only necessarily come from only one Excel report. Maybe I'll take data from one Excel report, the other Excel report, and many more Excel reports, and I present a summarized report at one common place. So yes, that is something important. For example, now as a training institute, I may want to know in a given month how many inquiries have come. Out of this, how many inquiries have been converted to join us as a regular student. I want to know this ratio, and I want to know this in past, how is my performance every month. I want to see the same performance quarterly. I may want to see this performance annually. And most important, I may want to compare this performance with my previous year performance. So I will have all the data available in Excel. But then I want to do a comparative study of these documents. So yes, there is something available in SharePoint which will give me with this kind of ability to view the reports in comparative way. You can create dashboards, scorecards and other views. That's what same thing. A key performance indicators can be there. Is my performance as per expectation? I can say in this particular month, I am supposed to make a revenue of XYZ amount. So did the organization really go to the extent where it has met the target, or was it below the target? So those are key performance indicators which can reflect to the user. So yes, Insight has been really enhanced from 2007 into 2010 now. The last pillar is composites, integrating your business systems. Another big improvement for SharePoint 2010 relates to is its ability to talk to, pushing or pulling data to or from business systems. Now, what do I mean by business systems? See, SharePoint need not use data only what is available with SharePoint. In SharePoint, I can use data maybe from my SAP system. My corporate already has an SAP system which is managing data. So SharePoint gives us facility where I can pull in data from SAP, I can pull in data from SQL Server, I can pull in data from my Excel, I can pull in data from an external Oracle system, I may have a data warehousing system from where I can pull in data, I can fetch data from different sources and make it available within the environment of the SharePoint itself. So rather than a user going to different systems for the small things, they can have collectively within SharePoint environment a common place to work with all the data. And this whole thing is done with the help of a feature called as Business Connectivity Service. How is this done? We will again see in our further course with a set of examples. So these are the six pillars of SharePoint: sites, communities, content, search, insights, composite. I would request you to by heart them. Somebody may ask you these things in the interview. What are the six pillars of SharePoint 2010? So just revise it once more and remember them forever. Of course, each of this is actually a syllabus topic which we are going to cover as we move further in our course. Now, version history. Yeah, SharePoint has actually come in 2001, though of course it has never become that popular as much as it is today. SharePoint initially came, and then in 2003 we had this WSS 2.0, SharePoint Services 2003, they called it. Here WSS stands for Windows SharePoint Server. So in 2003, 2.0 has come. In 2006, Windows SharePoint Server. SharePoint services, sorry, Windows SharePoint Service 2.0, Windows SharePoint Service 3.0, MOS, Microsoft Office SharePoint Server. Office 2007 is the version of SharePoint where extraordinary integration with MS Office product has happened. But now in 2010, the latest version, which was released in the year 2010 only, we have got SharePoint Foundation Server, which is of course free with basic features, and then we have got SharePoint Server 2010. The whole product actually is referred as SharePoint Server 2010. SharePoint Foundation Server is supposed to be a subset of SharePoint Server 2010. This is a software product which we'll have to purchase. It's not free, but SharePoint Foundation Server is free. Once we have a licensed version of Windows, we can simply use it. Now, where exactly SharePoint sits? practically, if you are an administrator, you would be probably very much interested in SharePoint. So let us say this is centralized SharePoint server. It is going to communicate with your Microsoft Exchange server for sending emails, or for that matter, even receiving emails. It is going to communicate with your SQL server for storing data and for retrieving data. It is going to communicate with a domain controller where the list of all usernames and their passwords are stored, so that it can verify the user credentials for authentication of the user. It can communicate with a server, file sharing server, where it can dump, you can take backup of your data, you can do public searches upon this data, so that this content becomes available to people all over the world, wherever, whatever you want, you can publish over here. So basically, you can see here, SharePoint is actually sitting in center of so many other servers here. So that's how I said, I keep repeating, SharePoint helps us to coordinate activities between different Microsoft products. SharePoint is not a software. SharePoint is a collection of products and technologies. What are the different components of SharePoint? So when I say SharePoint is a product, what are the different components? SharePoint Foundation Server. It's the closest equivalent of WSS in 2007. Windows SharePoint Server 2007. So creating team sites, collaboration on content with lists and libraries, features such as blocks, wikis, RSS feeds, alerts, easy browser-based customizations, all these basic features are available in Foundation Server. It provides developers with great platform to build from. Out of the box, it handles storage, web presentation, authorization, basically security, user management, information about users, and it has interface into Windows Workflow Foundation as well. And because all this functionality is easily accessible through object model, API, web services, it can be accelerated. It can accelerate a developer's job. All these features a developer can write code upon. Whatever data is there in SharePoint, SharePoint is managing. We can probably write scripts using C# as a programming language and fetch the data. So there is an API, an object model available for SharePoint Foundation Server for fetching data by developers. Rather than build all these infrastructure pieces into every web-based product, developers can leverage SharePoint Foundation and concentrate on just building the solution. Rather than programming things from ground up, we can actually take certain things from where SharePoint has left and build upon it, and it will be much more productive result is what it says here. And beautiful thing, SharePoint Foundation Server is free of cost. You just need to have a licensed version of Windows operating system, Windows 2008 server, and you can simply enable this service on that server, and you get all these things which are mentioned here free of cost. SharePoint Server 2010. It extends Foundation Server, which is automatically installed with SharePoint Server 2010. I told you before, SharePoint Foundation Server is a subset of SharePoint Server 2010. It is available in two editions, Standard Edition and Enterprise Edition. Standard Edition introduces core functionality like socializing, searching, advanced search, right, those things. Advanced web and enterprise content management, like document IDs are there. Then we have got tagging of content, document library. All those things I would say are part of advanced web enterprise content management. Enterprise focus primarily on adding functionality through new services applications, introducing business intelligence, line of business control, the sixth pillar, reporting, and some office client services such as Visio. All these features are supported in Enterprise Edition of SharePoint. So these two are the basic servers, Foundation Server, SharePoint Server 2010. Over and above that, we can have Search Server. Foundation Server cannot pull search results from multiple site collection. It cannot add external content sources like file share or Microsoft Exchange public folders. Search Server can do that for you. Search Server 2010 Express is free product from Microsoft that essentially takes SharePoint foundation and adds to it intranet searching capabilities. While Search Server 2010 can be configured to avoid any single point of failure, including the search components, it can be deployed only on server in farm, and it's not free. SharePoint Server is not free. SharePoint Server 2010 Express Edition is free. SharePoint Server 2010 can be configured to avoid any single point of failure. Fast server, visual search, best bets, extremely scalable, billions of documents can be searched, enhanced multi-language capabilities, better handling of unrestricted data through metadata extraction, better handling of structured data such as numbers, dates, etc. SharePoint Online. See, we all now very well know the world cloud is expanding. The cloud. If I want to have a SharePoint kind of environment within my organization, and if I am a startup organization, it would not be, may not be economically viable for me to have so much of investment made on hardware infrastructure before I can install SharePoint setup softwares on it. So to overcome this problem, Microsoft has now provided a SharePoint cloud. See, something really beautiful aspect of this is, suppose your company decides to go for SharePoint cloud. Frankly speaking, the job of SharePoint administrator is done. We don't need SharePoint administrator. You simply buy the cloud service of Microsoft for the SharePoint, of course. You don't have to do any kind of administration work. It comes built in with all those administration facilities. So yes, for a startup organization, it is absolutely not a bad idea to go for a SharePoint online product, which is basically a SharePoint cloud. You can actually say here, SharePoint cloud. Email and text messaging. Yeah, this is also one of the features which we have now. Then we have got application servers which are built in into SharePoint, query search, index server, Excel services, right, usage and health data collection. If suppose your hard disk is getting out of storage area, this health collection data will immediately give you a warning. The hard disk is going to fill very soon. Please take care of it. So these things, if there is a query which is taking more time and slowing down the system, that also can be taken care by the service which is available, application service which is available, and it will warn us or an appropriate administrator that so and so service and so and so activity is taking more time and slowing down the whole system. So these are the different components, I would say, which are part of SharePoint. SharePoint Foundation Server, SharePoint Server 2010, Search Server, Faster Server. Of course, this is not a component. This is one of the options available for hosting SharePoint sites. Then email and text messaging service, application servers, and so on. The most important part, developer's view of SharePoint. We as a developer, how do we see SharePoint? Now, we can call this actually as a SharePoint onion. Here you see solution development. See, there are three aspects I told you. First is configuration. We have everything ready-made. We simply configure it. There is no need of any technical knowledge, I would say, for simple configuration of a site. You need not be a developer. You need not be a designer. You simply configure it. Basically, I would say this is job of administrator. They need not know how to program, they need not know what is cascading style sheets, they need not know what is theme, but still they can manage the site by just doing configuration. Then whatever is built up, that I may want to customize it. At the time of customizing, we might have two roles. One is designer, the other is developer. For designer, we use a software of SharePoint referred as SharePoint Designer. SharePoint Designer now comes with MS Office and it is free of cost. You don't have to buy. So you just install SharePoint Designer and it gives you the ability of editing any web page of SharePoint in a designer to add or remove content from it, customize the content from it, move the content here and there. All that facility comes in SharePoint Designer. Then we can also use Visual Studio 2010 for programming content, but in customization, this is secondary role. Designer will play major primary role. But then going further deep, you will find that there are cases where a solution developer will use Studio properly. Visual Studio is what you are going to use. You may want to probably write custom workflows. You may want to have programming scripts generated. You may create custom web parts. You might do some integration with business connectivity service, external data you want to share it in SharePoint. So there the role of Visual Studio developer will be more and a designer will be less. In configuration, we create web parts, new sites and collections, columns, lists and libraries. For this, there is absolutely zero requirement of any programming skills. In customization, we customize styles, master pages, we modify list forms, we create workflows. Of course, we don't need coding for even creating workflow. Knowledge of ASP.NET before we do customization is really going to be beneficial. Only those people who know ASP.NET understand this master pages concept well. They understand what are these styles and so on. Workflows, configuration. So yes, here there is no prerequisite, but here I would put ASP.NET basics as a prerequisite. Though not in depth, but at least the basics of ASP.NET. Of course, in depth of HTML and cascading style sheet is the prerequisite for the customization part. Coming to the core, the development, yeah, you need to know complete ASP.NET in depth. Using ASP.NET, you are going to create custom controls, you are going to create web parts, you are going to create pages, you are going to create advanced workflows, and you are going to, of course, customize the sites and list definitions and integrate them into a SharePoint. So this is what I say is the onion view of SharePoint, developer's view of SharePoint. So yes, in this video we have covered, just to summarize quickly, what exactly is SharePoint. I'm pretty confident that now you know the power of SharePoint. You know a reason why SharePoint is getting day by day so much popular, why corporates are adapting to SharePoint, so that the things, especially in the intranet kind of environment. Again, let me clarify one very important thing. SharePoint is not going to become that popular, at least not in the near future, for public websites. SharePoint, you should always keep in mind, is ideally useful for a corporate intranet where there is a closed environment for data to be accessed, the content to be accessed by only those employees who are working in the organization. But I have seen some websites which even provide content of SharePoint to public on internet. Yes, there is a possibility, but that you have not, you should not, as a developer, as a designer, as an administrator, I would suggest you keep the corporate intranet in mind when you are trying to learn SharePoint. We covered high level features in simple language, same thing in more sophisticated language. We covered in 6 pillars of SharePoint, gave you a brief history of SharePoint versions which have come, the latest being SharePoint 2010, SharePoint Foundation Server and SharePoint Server 2010. What is the where exactly SharePoint sits, the centralized role, how it collaborates between different other servers of Microsoft, different components which are part of SharePoint, and of course lastly we covered what exactly is the developer's view, onion view, developer's onion view of SharePoint. What is the prerequisite for doing what? Where does SharePoint Server, SharePoint Designer software, and where does Visual Studio 2010 comes into the picture? That's all in this session. Thank you.